What works in autism? Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Smith. I'm an integrative medicine physician, and I've got about 20 years of experience doing that, and also about that much experience in treating autistic children. I've seen many children go from severe autism to off spectrum, and most children get a lot better. It really depends somewhat on the severity of the autism, but more importantly, on the ability of the parent to implement all the protocols. This is one of my favorite pieces of data. It's the parent rating of behavioral effects of biomedical interventions. Basically, it's what works and what doesn't work. It was done in 2009, and there are 27,000 parents involved here that completed their questionnaires. Now, not all of these parents did everything, but what we're recording is what got better, what got worse, and no effect, and then the ratio of better to worse, and the number of cases, so you can tell how much weight to give this intervention. This one, well, these had 1,300. Probably ought to listen to that pretty carefully. If you had like five or six, then that wouldn't be very good data. So let's go through this. We'll start with the drugs, which generally get pretty poor ratings from parents. Let's just first start by scanning this better-worse ratio. There's one that stands out. Diflucan, 13 to 1. And that would kill off fungal infections in the gut. Makes sense. 62% got better. Only 5% got worse. About a third didn't see much anything. Nystatin does the same thing, but the ratio is not as good. And then these are antihistamine stuff, chloral hydrates, things to sedate your child. And none of these did very well. So you can pretty much just wipe these off. 0.9 to 1, 0.9, 2.6. Well, these are not very good numbers. Secretin, which is an IV treatment, it's a lot of trouble to give, did get some results, but still the ratios are not impressive. If you had a seizure, then the seizure medication seems to work better than most, but in general, most of these drugs got an F. Look at phenobarbital, 0.3. 48% got worse, only 16% got better. If you did it for seizures, then it did work. Low-dose naltrexone, this is what we use to stimulate the immune system. It's a narcotic antagonist. But that's not how it works when you give it low dose. It stimulates the immune. It did have a positive effect, not too many side effects. So that's worth trying. Now we're going down to the biomedical. This is supplements mainly and diet. And here we get much better numbers. Look at these numbers. 30 to 1, 32 to 1, 28. That's pretty much all that's in the diet. So that should be telling you, well, maybe I should change my child's diet. We've got 30 to 1 chance. I'll take that bet at the track every day. So you've got a pretty good chance of getting good results. And the gluten and casein-free diet is the one we use the most, because most people know what gluten is, the protein in wheat, casein's protein in dairy. So lots of information on the internet about what's got gluten and what's got casein. Only 3% got worse. About a third didn't do well. Didn't get worse, didn't get better. But look how many got better. And that's a lot of cases, 3,500. So that's one to try. The other one is specific carbohydrate diet. This is specific foods that are easy to digest so that undigested food does not get down in deep into the intestine or into the colon, where bacteria will eat it and get overgrowth or yeast overgrowth. Rotation diet, this is for reducing allergy responses. If you eat a food every 3 days, you'll minimize. Every 7 days, you'll maximize. So these are really good things in removing eggs and dairy. So what you want to do with this is keep a log. Try these diets, give them a month, keep a log, especially for foods, because The rotation diet, if you eat a food every 3 days, you'll minimize reactions. You eat the same food and you wait 7 days, you'll maximize. So you can eat the same food and get two different kinds of reactions depending on the space between, the time between when you're eating it. So that's where a log will tell you. You say, oh, I can't, don't understand why he ate those bananas before and now he's having a reaction. Well, look at the log. If there was 3 days one time and 7 days or 6 days another, you would expect to see more of a reaction at 6 to 7 days, and maybe you wouldn't see any reaction at 3 days. So a log is very helpful. So let's go over to the supplements. I'm going to keep this somewhat short. I'm going to go over the ones that I found that work really well. Cod liver oil. And this is rich in vitamin A. It's a natural form of vitamin A. 2,500 cases, only 4% got worse, 55% and 14 to 1. So I'd stop and write that down. Cod liver oil. I'm going to try my child on that. Detoxification, chelation. We'll go over that another video, but 74% got better. Why is that? Well, most autistic children have methylation and genetic issues that slow their detoxification. Children in general will absorb something like lead. They'll absorb about 50% of it, where an adult might only absorb 10%. So sponges anyway. And if they have a methylation defect, then they can't excrete. And there's some very gentle little sprays you can spray in the mouth, and let's help pull out these heavy metals. Digestive enzymes, look at this one. 19 to 1, 62% got better. And this makes sense. You break down the food and it's absorbed better. So there's not a bunch of leftover food for the bacteria to feed on in overgrowth or to feed candida or other fungus. So want to put those on your list. So you should have cod liver oil, chelation, digestive enzyme. DMG, pretty good. 5.3 to 1, maybe put that on a later list. Food allergy treatment, there's several of those. We don't have enough time to go over all those, but that's something to look at, and there's several ways to test. Hyperbaric definitely does work, 12 to 1, but I find it doesn't keep very well, and it's expensive. So I would put that, and it was only 219. So I would not put that at the top of my list, but maybe later on. Here's one I would put right at the top. I put virtually every child on B12 subcutaneous shots. Now, when I first heard this, you're going to give a shot to an autistic child, that's crazy. No, we use it. And it's easy to give. These shots just go under the skin. You can give them so fast, they don't know what hit them. And they work. 72% of the time, they last about 3 days. And you can see if they work. You just let them wear off, give them 5 days, give the shot again, see, watch the behavior. You'll see a pattern. And so this is definitely one I would do. Now, this is going to require a prescription. And if you don't have a functional medicine doctor, and they're pretty scarce, you may be able to talk your pediatrician into doing this, because there's a low downside. And just make sure the pediatrician knows that you're not going to hold them responsible if it doesn't work very well, and usually there's no problems with this. The side effects, if you get it too deep, you'll get red urine. It's just going into the muscle and going out too fast. Or you get a little red spot in the skin because you got too shallow. Neither one are permanent. So these are easy to do. B6 is another one that works really well on a lot of children. Not as much as some of the others, 4.3, but 48% got better. And this really depends on your child's genetics. And you really want to do a genetic test. I recommend the 23andMe. Then this becomes less trial and error and more specific, because by identifying which enzymes are not functioning optimally, you also will know which supplements you need to account for that. For example, I have a 677, MTHFR 677, so I take L-methylfolate. My wife has an MTHFR 1298. I give her methyl B12. And the joke around the house is my behavior gets much better when she gets her methyl B12 shot. TMG is another methylator, as is DMG. I would not add those right at the beginning, but something to keep in mind. So again, methyl B12, that should be right on that list. Melatonin works pretty good. Small dose, 1 to 2 milligrams. transfer factors, these are immune things. Vitamin A, I wouldn't use that because it's basically you're giving it in cod liver oil. And you get 14 to 1, 44%, 55%. So well, you can do it either way, but usually the cod liver oil is what I would use. Vitamin C seems to be a no-brainer. 2% gut worse, 46%, 20 to 1. And that comes in multiple methods. You have little lozenges they can take and other things. Zinc, 24 to 1. And I would add trace minerals to that. I've done hundreds and hundreds of trace mineral studies. I've never found a normal one on either adults or children. So I'm just going to assume that they're going to be deficient and give them a trace mineral. They're very inexpensive. And then we've got to the diets that we've covered already. So there you have it. Those are things to try. I would go through this list, and again, you'll be able to download this, and make a list of the ones you want to try, and then keep records, do them. If you can find a physician or naturopath that can help guide you with this, that'll be very helpful. You'll need a physician to give you the methyl B12 shots. All the rest of this is available like on our site, Agape Nutrition, or other sites that have these types of supplements. So thank you very much for paying attention. And good luck with your child. This is a very treatable disorder.